Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning again. Focus of attention in the gospel today, a costly perfume oil. So isang taong sahod daw, one full year's wages, 300 days. Siguro ngayon yan yung $100 per ounce na perfume. Estee Lauder siguro, Helena Rubinstein, baka may Dickie Inouye. Pinapanood ko minsan yung Cosmopolitan at saka Vogue magazine ng mga kababaihan eh. So, very expensive oil, very expensive perfume. Pinangpunas lang sa paa ni Jesus. Oil, sabi ni Judas, kung tininda pa yan, marami tayong matutulungan na mahirap. Pero sabi ng gospel, he wanted the money so that he can steal it. But the objective of the woman, Mary, was to give honor to Jesus, because in Jewish culture, you always give water to your guests so that they can wash their feet. It's not only water that's given, expensive perfume. 1 year's wages of an ordinary laborer. What is this trying to tell us? The gospel wants us to learn that we have different aims. And we should examine that. More than 60 years ago, I entered the seminary, that building. Since I was already fifth year of engineering from UST, they told me, you just study Latin and then you go to theology. So I studied Latin. And our professor was very good, could make you long-term retention, is what the teachers call it. One of the things that I never forget, Father Peter Michael, lived to be 104 years old, and in his old age could still remember the poems of Virgil in the Aeneid. But he taught us res pice finem in Latin. What does it mean? It means, respite, yung tignan mong mabuti. Yung huli. Look at your objectives. Stephen Covey, in his book, The Seven Habits of Effective People, also says this. He says, begin with the end in mind. You start everything with what will happen. So Judas, his end, overtly, sa panlabas, to help the poor. But his real objective is that the perfume should be sold so that he could steal from the money bag. Siya ang treasurer. So let us pray for all treasurers today, especially national treasurers. The woman had a different objective, to give honor to Jesus. So the lesson I would like to share with you today is that we will be happier human beings if we follow res pice finem. What is my objective? Because sometimes we are very weak, we are frail, we are easily distracted. You come into the seminary, respite finem, to become a priest, and suddenly there's a pretty girl, and then you forget your objective. Come into the convent, objective, perpetual vows. But sometimes we are distracted because there are by few things, little things, superior does not like us, respect him. So it was not totally paradise. I had a very happy seminary training, but there were a lot of problems too. So if there are problems, look to the end. It will give you strength. Like the old lady wanted to worship in the temple with her cane, walking very slowly. And some people were worried. Old lady, will you still be able to arrive to walk up the mountain to the temple? She said, I can't, because my heart is already there. I have to drag this carcass up there to follow my heart. Respice finem. So I would like to ask, young ladies, what do you want to do with your life? Respice finem. The millennials and the Generation Z, the teenagers, what is your respite finem in spending 10 hours a day in social media? Because respite finem also says, what will be the result if this is my objective? For example, you play Genshin Impact and Mobile Legends and Valorant hours a day. Respite finem. What's your real objective? Just to be entertained? Just to get the levels para makapagyabang ka na 5 stars ka na, mataas ka na ang level? Respite finem. Kayong lahat ng mga kabataan. Many of you are sad according to the surveys. You are connected but you are alone. Wala kayong makakausap tungkol sa the deeper feelings that you have. Respite finem. That's the life that you want? Yung lahat ng mga butante, it's our duty to remind you that it is a sacred act. Anong kahihinatnan ng bansa kung yun ang pipiliin mo sa May 9? Respect si Finet. Mahalaga din. So lahat tayo, titigdan natin. Even I'll be 50 years priest next year. Respect si Finet. I'm always going to our cemetery. That will be my end. But as long as I breathe, I will try to help the poor. So respect si Finet will also sharpen your strategies. Help the poor. Papakainin mo na lang ba yan? Feeding program ka na lang ba? Magpasawalang hangga? So what we are trying, I was in Smoky Mountain the other day, that's the former garbage dump. I stayed there for 30 years. We are making the Sandiwaan Learning Innovation Hub. That's my end now. That's my respite finem. We will build a computer center for high-flex learning. That means you could teach in the traditional way, you could teach online, or you could use a learning management system where the kids can do it on their own when they have time. Just like what they are doing now with their music in Spotify, lalagay lang nila yan, papakinggan nila pag may panahon na sila. High flex learning is my objective to help the poor. Judas also wanted to help the poor, but he had no strategies. Respite finem. Please pray for our Sandiwaan Learning Innovation Hub as our strategy to really help the poor. Hindi mo kayang pakainin na lang magpasawalang hanggan yan. So respite finem. That's what I learned. 60 years ago, I'm still trying to do it as I move towards retirement. I hope I will die with my boots on, hindi yung lalagay ka doon sa ICU na ilang taon ka na doon. But I will accept what God will say. But to the last breath, respite si finem. I will help the poor, plant 1 billion bamboo, help the farmers using technology. respite finem, may vision ka of what should happen in the future, and you pray for God's grace so that you will find the strength and the right methods so that you could reach your objective. And that is our prayer for today's Mass, for our life. Respite finem, so that you can answer the question of why you are here in this universe. Lagi kang kumakain mula kay Mother Earth. Anong bayad mo daw? Ba't narito ka kasama nitong mga bituin at saka mga galaxies? Why are you here? Respite finem.